Nickelodeon dedicated a show to describing why it's so important to take care of the environment, because not just of the trees and the birds and the fish, but because of environmental racism.
Black snow, the thick soot that pollutes Pahokee, Florida. There's Cancer Alley, which is an area along the Mississippi River in Louisiana that's lined with oil refineries. And air so toxic in New York's South Bronx that 20% of children have asthma. What do these cities have in common? They're all examples of environmental racism, a form of systemic racism, where minority and low-income communities are surrounded by health hazards because they live near sewage, mines, landfills, power stations, major roads. In Philadelphia, it's hazardous waste. In San Carlos, Arizona, it's a mining project that would dishonor an Apache sacred site. But it has never been more devastating and harmful than in Duplin, North Carolina, where, believe it or not, the number of hogs outnumber the number of residents.
My name is Fiona. I grew up in Duplin County, North Carolina.
Fiona moved away from Duplin County as soon as she could, which is why she's okay opening up about life there.
Okay, hold on. Did you see the issue? All of their claims they're building up to, which is they're really dubious claims that in poor areas, you're seeing different demographic groups who are disproportionately poor. Those areas are not as nice as rich areas. Okay, yep, makes it not exactly groundbreaking stuff. And this constitutes environmental racism. I'm not totally buying into that. And it's all about race, and the races are stuck there. And then the woman says, yeah, I moved away as soon as I could. Ah, wait, right, you can just move away. You can just leave. You can go somewhere else. I'm not saying it's easy to go somewhere else, but you can. Okay, you're not locked down, you're not chained there. The reason they have to talk about environmental racism, though, is because we've lost our moral discourse. We can't talk about the objective moral order. We can't really talk about good and evil and right and wrong because the left has undermined belief in those things. So the only way we can talk about evil now is by calling it racism. Racism is the ultimate expression of evil. Even when it has nothing to do with race, like you're talking about the environment and areas that have more pollution than other areas, but you have to call it racism in order to, and that's also because we've lost our ability to have metaphysical discourse, so we've only got to talk about physical things. So the evil things have to do with just, they have to only go skin deep. Total nonsense trying to get at a bizarre perversion of what all of politics ultimately comes down to, which is, yes, some things are good, some things are bad, some things are right, some things are wrong. But we're not allowed to say that anymore because we've embraced this radical subjectivism of the left. Hey, wait a second. Don't go anywhere. I've had some people write into me and they say, Michael, for some reason, I'm not getting notifications for your show. Hey, Michael, for some reason, even when I search for your show, the videos aren't always popping up. Yeah, I think it's because our overlords don't love us necessarily in this big tech space. Make sure you smash that button. You like, you subscribe, you do everything in your power to get those notifications. You still probably won't get them, but it'll give you a better chance of not missing a single video.